Ferguson speaking to you from the 1980 men's final at Wimbledon. Welcome back if you're just joining us. And you are in for a treat, because what a thrilling match we've witnessed so far. The players, Björn Borg on the west end of the court, headband pulled tight across his forehead, framing an impassive face. And on the west side, John McEnroe, the brash New Yorker who has been christened Super Brat by the press. Now, one thing that must be mentioned is the confusion resulting from McEnroe's indecisiveness in playing left or right-handed. Now, this may be due in part to several things. We may consider what some critics have labeled his apparent bipolar disorder, which would also account for his sudden outbursts on the court, and that the left and right sides of his brain are simply fighting for control over his limbs. There is also a predisposed dyslexic condition on his mother's side. Then again, there is always the possibility of a wanton ambidextrosity in simply not knowing his right from his left. John McEnroe, quite possibly with liquid paraffin pumping through his arteries, so combustible are some of his on-court behaviors. They are now about to pick up the match in the fourth set tiebreak. They're just warming up following a brief stoppage of play caused by problems with the grass, seemingly due to a negligent member of the grounds crew. After a rather lopsided opening set in which McEnroe dominated, Björn Borg has found his form and turned this into a real contest. Both players have had their chances, but the momentum is with the defending champion now as he'll try to close out the match in this tiebreak to claim an unprecedented fifth consecutive title. Without question, the big issue of the entire fortnight has been whether Björn Borg will finally be toppled or will he win his fifth title in a row. We'd have to go back almost a century to the great British champion William Renshaw, who held the title from 1881 until 1887, to find another player who has so dominated this championship as Borg has done. So the Swede is truly on the verge of something unprecedented here on these hallowed grounds in this temple of tennis. But not if the brash young American has anything to say about it. If he can contain his nerves and muster all of the potential that he has shown thus far in the match, then we'll go to a fifth set. The crowd here at the All England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club are not impressed with the upstart's antics.
What do you have to do to overcome your opponent in this match?
Well, you know, Borg's got a, you know, got a great baseline game. You know, he's got a strong forehand, he's got a strong serve, and what I have to do is come to the net, attack him, put pressure on him, you know, and really attack his nerves and see if I can overcome, you know, the Borg.
So. Final question: crowd's pretty intense today. You're expecting a lot. How do you block all that out? How do you put that aside?
I don't let it get to me. I just keep my head down. You know, win or lose the point, on to the next one. Crowd, no crowd, just play my game.
And the young American, John McEnroe, aged 21, is ranked number 2 overall. Well, it looks as though the players are just about ready.
6 games all. Quiet, please. 6 games all. The tiebreak will now come under operation. McEnroe to serve first. Quiet, please.
The final has ended on the tiebreak. Yes, it's a million cyber radios.
It's hard to get there.
Love one.
And it's all about nerves now.
To serve 5-6. Five, change ends in 6-all.
Unbelievable reflexes. I was going to get on walk between his better points.
Borg to serve 7-6. Serve 9-10. quiet during the tiebreak, Rain. This is not your backyard. Out. 10-0.
Serve 11-10. We're serving now on Borg's serve. Championship in 6.
To serve 11-12.
and it was just a fraction of an inch on it, was a true one.
Ball to serve, 14-15.
On the fifth occasion, the board has had to try and save himself. At least it's on his serve.
Change ends, 15-0.
Well, the sign is a good match to the classic, and it was a match to the standard.